Very interesting table about the ninth of Av this year. Now, before showing you the table, let us see very interesting gematria and numerical value of the word in Hebrew, Tisha B'Av, which is 9 of Av, and the numerical values comes to 800, which is the same numerical value, gematria, like in 5778, B'Tavshinayin Chet, in 5778, which comes to also 800. So altogether, very, very interesting. Speaking about the ninth of this year, let us see what the table shows us about it. So in this table you see here, Tisha B'Av, the ninth of Av, parallel to it, a little bit higher, but it's parallel, which is very significant, Tavshin Ayin Chet, 5778. And parallel is very significant. Professor Yves says, Dr. Rotenberg, this is really the program that we are using, is his, he became Orthodox Jew, keeping Torah mitzvot, because he saw the phenomena of the code, which is a clear proof, the Torah from heaven. And also scientists says, if it is true, it's the greatest discovery in the last 100 years, but there is a Satan, you know, that disturbed to bring people to a belief. But there are like Professor Michelson from Harvard, became an Orthodox Jew, and he said it was because of the phenomena of the course, and also Dr. Rotenberg, that he is, this is his program we are using, he also became Orthodox Jews as a result of it, and quite few. But still it's difficult because people don't like to change their life, to believe in the Torah, to keep the Torah, the Sabbath, purity of life, and all other things which they cannot do when they believe except the Torah. But this is, as we told you, this is really unbelievable because you have here the ninth of Av with this year, and you have best meeting of Messiah and Moses. You know, this is the same skip, Messiah, Mashiach, and Moses, and this is exactly according to what the idea that is written in the Medrash, everywhere, that with Messiah, Moses will come. Yeah, Moses is also in the numerical value of Shiloh. And also it's written that Elijah will come with Moses, with Mashiach. Also Moshe and Elijah come, unbelievable, yeah? Then what we have here is the verse saying, Goel, Igal, the Redeemer will redeem you, right? He bring you redemption and salvation, Shua, also Shua. But overall, it have always been said, the Maimonides, Rambam says, and Israel Nigalim, Israel will not be redeemed unless they do Tshuva, or a small skip of Tshuva coming here. And as the Rambam said, if Jews will not do it willingly, apparently God will see that it will happen. Who knows if not as a result of wars or troubles, it looks like it's a very serious situation in Israel. If one saw what is going on these nights in Israel with the Hamas, and all this Iran, they are pushing it, definitely don't give them quiet, yeah. And this is exactly what clearly the prophet said. As you remember, I brought you an amazing table about Sephaniah saying that troubles will take place in future, towers will be destroyed, Nasham Apinotam, Saturday, their fields, places will be empty of people, earthquake, tsunamis, everything describes there. And then God said, I did everything, Achentik Humusa, I did all the things in the world that you will see what is going on, earthquakes, towers falling now, and floods, tsunamis, lava comes out from mountains, survive, and does not move people. Okay, interesting, so many tragedies coming, happening, doesn't move people. So God said afterwards, Lachen, because I waited for you to repent. Lachen, Chakuli, now wait for me. And then come a verse with 26 verses, a God named Gematria, with 27 letters of the alphabet appearing there, 22 and 25, once in the whole Bible, unbelievable. And this is a Gog and Magog, description of Gog and Magog. This is a commentator says that. In Sephaniah chapter 3, verses 6, 7, 8, 9. And then the ninth one said, ah, then when all this will happening, Magog wars, fighting, ah, the epoch El Amim Safabu, then I will convert the people into a pure language, which is the Hebrew. So he said, the whole world will realize the Hebrew language, which is what is behind. It's behind a lot of things behind the Hebrew letters of the world. The worlds were created with the Hebrew letters. I wrote about more than 20 books about the Hebrew language connecting with anything in the world, because this is the basis of creation, as Zohar said. Bereshit bara Elohim et, when God created the Hebrew letters, which are the basis of creation. And this is what the world will realize. As a foch al harim safa bua al amim, on the nation of a foch, I will turn to convert people into pure language, and they will realize the Hebrew language. Also, in Hebrew, safa bua, clear language, is gematria of Lashon HaKodesh, the Holy Tongue. It's amazing to see all these things coming here, you know, Tisha B'Av, the month of Av, which is this year, such important year, and a time that we need salvation, we need redemption, and the most important thing to do tshuva, repentance, and then we'll have Messiah coming with Moses. And amazingly, if you go back or down into this table, you have temple. Yeah, we are promised if you keep tshuva, ninth of Av, so the temple, the Mikdash, will be built with Son of Jesse, comes here also, and all come in one place, yeah? All in the same table, as you can see. So all together, as you said, very interesting and important. Now also I want to tell you that after doing so many YouTubes of Masri Sound, and I don't see that, I don't feel that it moves people, and for me it's important to teach Torah, to teach Gemara. I am now in Monsi, and there is Yeshiva, of many boys, Israelis many, who became religious. I used to teach a while ago, and I have to do it now also, because I feel that really doing YouTubes and working on it is interesting, people say, but to change people, to realize what the rabbi says, that it should bring people to understand the Torah is from heaven, and the scientist says that if it is right, it is the greatest discovery in the 300 years. So, meantime, I don't see it's really moving, so what I will be now, if you will not see me doing every day on YouTube, don't be surprised, because I want to teach in yeshiva, to learn there, you see. And then if I see something interesting is happening, so I will try to do a YouTube. So this is, as I said, very interesting, that it is really, you saw that it fits with the gematria, amazing, ninth of Av. Comes exactly line in Tafshin Ayin Chet. It's in English, but it is Bet Tafshin Ayin Chet in several senses. So, you know what is the idea behind how it comes together, this table with the Gematria, which fits so much our time, this year, Tafshin Ayin Chet, 5778. So, let us hope that really something will bring people, Jews, to repent, to keep the Sabbath, not to do pride parade, be showing. Brings the wrath of us and anger from God, because it's one of the very, very abominable, this is the Torah calls it, abominable. Homosexuality, the Torah calls it very abominable, the book of Deuteronomy. So, this is really which brings trouble. This is why Jews find so many problems, difficulty to solve the problem with the Hamas, because I showed them another table that it goes together. Desecration, the Shabbos, Israel still carrying on desecration, the Shabbat. And more pride parade in more cities. It is so it's frightening that the ambassador of Israel took place in a parade, pride parade in New York, together with Ireland, who just now decided not to buy products from Yehudah v'Shomron. This is amazing. You can see so clearly the hand of God in what is going on. So important table, significant table. And let us hope that really it will move people to do tshuva.